This is Marcin from InfoDiagram. In this video you will learn three ways to make your slide stand out using bitmap fillings like watercolor. You will learn how to fill boring gray icons with realistic watercolor strokes, how to use same filling to smart arts like process flows, and finally how to paint charts with watercolor texture. So let's start. In this video, I'm going to use the following elements: icon in vector format, watercolor fillings. By the way, they were painted on the real paper and processed by our designer Iza. And I will use this smart art, and finally little bar chart. Alright, so let's start with an icon. So I'm going to take this vector icon, paste it in here. Please note that that's a vector icon, so to check it out, if I resize, the edges remain very sharp, you do not see pixels over here. So I want to make this cloud a little bit more blue, so we'll take this texture, I copy it, then select the icon. And now I will go to Format menu and select Shape Fill, and here I go to Texture. So you can select one of the standard textures provided with PowerPoint, but I will go to More Textures and select Picture or Texture Fill. So it automatically took what I had in my clipboard, but in case PowerPoint does not pick it up, you can press clipboard here to make sure it's applied. Alright, please note the edges of this cloud, so this shape is not fully covered with the paint, so we can create another one which will be fully covered with the paint. And to do that, I will use this texture, so I copy it, go back to our clouds and apply once again a picture or texture fill from clipboard, and it's done. So we have nice blue clouds, but let's assume you need to add some sadness to your presentation for some reason. So we can take these clouds and go to empty slide, and we can change the color of the clouds within few clicks. So I will go to Picture Tools and Format, and here select color, and here I can select from the palette of the colors of my presentation template. So these are the standard colors embedded in the template of the presentation, so I can quickly create some gray clouds which will change the mood of the presentation. Let's move on to smart arts. So I have a standard smart art over here, and I will apply this blue texture to elements of the smart art. So to do that, I copy the texture, I select the element I want to change and press Ctrl and V, so paste. I will do the same for the remaining elements, so I can do this also to these arrows, and the similar way as in the vector shapes, I can change the color of the filling, going to Picture Tools, Format and Color. Can do the same for these elements. And that's the final result. Let's make something different here. Now let's work with this chart. So this is standard chart in PowerPoint. and I want to apply this blue texture to the first column. So I copy it, go to my chart, select the bar and paste the filling. So I can also change the color of the texture, but this time it's a bit tricky. So before applying the texture to the chart, I need to recolor it to the desired color. So I change the color, copy it once again, select the bar and paste. So I will do the same for the remaining column. Paste it here. And that's the final result. Please note that legend also changed the color over here. So that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you will find it useful. In case of any questions, just leave a comment or contact me directly at marcin@infodiagram.com. Have a great day. Thank you.